In this episode, I'm going to show you the importance that sound can make. Yes, sound is the second thing I want to talk about in my series of what I think is the most important thing to make a good video, and that is sound. In this episode, I'm going to talk to you about the second most important thing that I think is important in good videos, and that is, that's right, sound, and the difference sound can make. In this video, I'm going to show you the importance that, you guess it, what sound makes to make a good video. I've opened up this video using three different types of recording devices. First was the onboard microphone of the Canon, which is pretty horrible. Second, I used a shotgun microphone. And third, in this sequence here, I'm using a lavalier microphone. So that's what I'm going to review, is the advantages and let you hear the differences, but I'm also going to close out this video with ideas on how you can make your present microphone just sound that much better. So let's talk about first the onboard microphones. Now the Canon has actually a horrible onboard microphone, and that's the one that I opened up with. And you'd be surprised that paying thousands for a camera, you'd think they'd have a better mic, but they don't. So I wanted to improve my sound, and I went to eventually a lavalier. But other cameras have great onboard microphones. This is my very first camera, and some of you may be using something like this. It's called a camcorder. And this one has two onboard mics. What I like about them is that they're very good microphones. They're high sensitivity, and they're also in stereo. That's actually a pretty decent sound, and I was very happy with the sound when I was using this camcorder. So if you've got a device like this, there's no need for you to upgrade unless you have a little extra cash laying around and you want to get a better sound like a lavalier. So the onboard mic, not bad, but with the Canon and some of these newer HDSLRs, you probably are going to have to go with an external type of microphone. Second type of microphone I showed you was what's called a shotgun microphone. Now this is a very low-end one. I got it at a really good price, and I just really wasn't that impressed with it. But it's called a shotgun microphone because it sits up on your shoe, your hot shoe. And as you see, it's a boom mic. This one is also stereo, as it shows you here on the microphone itself. But you point it at your subject, and you plug it into your mic jack, and away you go. Not bad. This one is called the Azden SMX-10, and if you look it up, you'll see that it's not really pricey, but then you get what you pay for. But nice thing you can do with a shotgun microphone is, I don't have the cable here with me, you can actually get an external cable and make your microphone even longer, and now you're using it, you know, out in the field if you needed to, if you had to go that way. The third type of microphone is the one that I'm using, and it's a lavalier. Okay, some of the features that I like about the lavalier, it just has the direct sound. There's no distance between, or I should say, there's not much distance between where my volume is coming from and getting picked up by the microphone right here. That's why it sounds so good. I mean, you heard the differences in the opening of this video. In, I believe, the first microphone, you could hear our fountain down the hill. It picked everything up. But with the lavalier, it's pretty much staying close right to my chest to pick up my voice. The second feature that I think is just well worth it is just that as Kim turns and does gardening or does whatever it is she's doing, the sound stays with her. I mean, you can hear that the voice never goes away from the microphone, and you lose some of that sound when your subject turns. That doesn't happen with the lavalier. So those are the two big reasons why I like using a lavalier. Okay, by way of closing out, I want to share with you some tips that you can do to enhance or make better with the current situation that you're using for your mics. Number one, whether you're using an onboard mic or even a shotgun mic, see if you can get a hold, if wind is a problem constantly, get a hold of a windsock or a windscreen, or this is also referred to as a dead cat. And it simply just slides over your microphone and just absorbs then any wind or additional movement. But you gotta check that out and play back your recording and test it, because sometimes it may muffle too much and you really don't want that kind of sound. So check that out and see how that works for you. Here's a different type of windsock that actually comes with this microphone, or windscreen, I should say, and it just works that way nicely. Okay? If you do not have any of these types of devices laying around, this foam or anything,
What you can do is also just take a piece of old nylon fabric and, you know, again, just whatever camera you have, just wrap it around so, like that. It will help muffle as well. And if wind is an issue, even on your onboard microphone, you may want to consider just lightly just taping something over the top like that if it's really, really windy out, and that may help with the sound as well. Again, always do a check though. Play back your recording so you can see how it sounded. Some of you had said that you actually put the camera in a box and the box shields the wind from the microphone. So that's another great idea in the way to do it. So again, you can have sound like this,
or you can have sound like this, the shotgun microphone, or you can do this, the onboard camera microphone.
So I hope you found this video helpful, just to show you the difference that sound can make. If you're not even near the place where you can get a lavalier or get a shotgun microphone, don't worry about it. Just keep making videos, do the best you can with what you've got, and make them well. Hopefully some of these tips that were shown here in this video today will help you just to improve the sound that you have now. Thanks again for watching. Hope you enjoyed the series so far, and I'm looking forward to the next video. Bye.